Adra has grown into the crevices of these weathered shelves like fungus pushing past stone and copper. Greetings, spirit. A hazy form stands before you. From time to time, the blurring features resolve into what you take to be an elven man. I can't do this anymore. How am I going to explain? How can we possibly give him what he wants? The spirit speaks in quick, hushed bursts of Engwithan, and shakes his head as if to answer his own questions. He's going to kill me. He's killed so many. Why should he stop here? Who is going to kill you? Great Father, Master, Ad Nua, I am trying all that I can do. All of us are. But we have come to the edge of what is possible. What are you doing here? I'm hiding. I passed by one of the machines and I couldn't breathe. I was thinking about the work we've done, the things we've seen, how even small deeds can scar the soul. Is mine so ragged? Will Ad Nua's son be grateful when we have torn him from his rest? Who are you? He has brought so many people down here. I hear such terrible things from the upper floors. Even here, these constructs. I cannot sleep. His voice lowers. I think sometimes that I will wake and find myself inside one of the animats. Will I even know? Will it not be like waking one day to find myself blind and mute? What does he want? The figure paces a few steps, raising his hands to his temples. What we cannot give him. Even after all this time, there is so much we do not know. He wants his son, the boy he knew, whole and preserved, returned to him. But people, souls, they don't always remember. Who's to say his son will remember being his son at all? Remember his father's face? I have seen mothers forget their children. How could you do all this? I'm not sure what he's doing. Are you still loyal to Ad Nua? Of course. I am a devoted servant. His voice goes high with terror. I didn't mean, please, I never meant that I would ever renounce my oaths. Oh, what? Had a problem there. It is only that I fear him. The figure shivers, looking at something beyond you. One may fear a lord and obey him still. It is, in fact, far easier than your alternative. I thought that, the game had crashed. Oh, apparently it has crashed. Okay, let's try again talking to this guy. Or spirit. Clicking didn't work. I hit the number key and that worked. Excuse me. What are you doing here? Who are you? What does he want? Are you still loyal? It is only that I fear him. The figure shivers, looking at something beyond you. One may fear a lord and obey him still. It is, in fact, far easier than the alternative. Okay.
Slowly now.
Alright, hit that thing, and yes, that opens that. What remains of this statue suggests it once depicted a young warrior. There are runes along the base, and at the statue's feet is a name, Maros. Maros. Any traps on this chest? Suppose not. Bracers of Deflection. Ooh, plus 9 deflection. Let's see what we got. Reflex. This attack speed. It's got accuracy. What do you think? I don't use this light endurance. It's not really helpful any longer. Plus one perception isn't that great, so let's put the spider finger gloves away and let's use bracers of deflection. Boom. Anything else around here? Secrets? Other than that? He's like he's guarding this. The Flames of Faerion. This saber has posed a mystery to historians and weaponsmiths for two centuries. It was recovered from an Engwithan ruin, but almost all experts agree that it is far younger than any of the artifacts left by that ancient civilization. Yet no one has been able to explain the runes on the blade, which are unmistakably Engwithan. The one fact on which all have agreed is that it is a formidable, if poorly understood, weapon. It's a saber. Damage. Grants fireball. Definitely hits harder than that sword. But it doesn't have the attack speed. Same burn damage. Got the fireball though, that's pretty awesome. We should give that to Kana. What does he have as far as abilities? Talents. Weapon focus adventure. Doesn't include this. Poleaxe, Estoc, Flail, Wand Warp. Well, he's not using it anyway. I got Weapon Focus Knight. Battleaxe, Sword, Morning Star, Crossbow. Unless if the saber is considered a kind of sword. Two-handed weapon, though. One-handed. I'm not using all his abilities because he gets a bonus when using a two-handed weapon, and we have him with one-handed. The saber's also one-handed, though. Well, I don't know. Trying to find him a one-handed thing soon, I guess. So I won't use that. Fireball, though, is pretty sweet. to say. Alright, let's get out of here. Still have to check out up here and around this corner. Dead end this way, right?
Eyes open.
I'm not completely sure. Yeah. Yeah, so I basically played this whole part over again, guys. I don't know why it crashed like that. Can't say. Don't step foot inside the thing. No. No! Ay! No! No! Oh well, at least we got rid of it. Trying to veer them away. I should have just paused it. You're not sneaking.
Yes?
Yes, you need to sneak.
No problem.
Especially with those things around. Seems like we should be able to zoom in a little more.
Following your lead.
That's not very helpful.
Then let this be helpful. Look like chocolate covered pretzels with little drips of white chocolate around. Are these the souls that were inside the Adra armor? We could talk to one of them apparently. Crossbow and an emerald. Greetings. Come, help me here. This spirit holds his hands just above the shattered machine, poised as if to pull on some unseen component. Brace there, and we'll be rid of this one. Each word seems to resolve itself in your mind an instant after it's spoken, as you recall the Engwithan tongue. He waits a moment, evidently for someone to take up position. Pull hard now. There. He sags back, wiping his brow. These machines, to think how many souls have felt their touch, and how many of those willing, I wonder. What has happened here? Do not worry, with Adnua slain, the rest have shown their true colors. Most have fled, some scattered into the tunnels. The fools. Come, they've already started sealing the upper floors. We'll be the last out at this rate. Don't think you made it out. Doros means to work some spell upon that door. Use Odd Nua's servants against him. What kind of spell? He cannot unmake the door entirely, but he can change its purpose. The oath, you see. If Odd Nua's servants are pledged to his defense, then we shall pledge ourselves to his destruction. The man gives you a fierce grin, turning away, and from one step to another he has faded, only to appear once more beside the machine. He toils silently at the broken machine, straining to pull free components long destroyed. You're breaking the machines? It would go faster if we knew what enchantments were upon them. They might as easily be activated as destroyed. He grins a little. Don't worry. I knew what I was doing. Come. They've already started sealing the upper floors. We'll be the last out at this rate. Yeah. Spell upon that door. What door? There must be 100 souls affixed to that stone. A punishment, no doubt. Perhaps they'll be pleased, knowing that Odd Nua goes wailing to the afterlife. Someone told me what door. How vexing.
Quickly and quietly.
Interesting. Is the door through here? We've been through here. We're on the other side. Oh, I didn't realize there was a doorway through there, and I went away. Never mind. I guess they mean this door.
Time to see and not be seen.
Shangri-La ahead. Oh, shut up.
Following your lead.
Damaged Spectre. One of these things are going to teleport. You know it, and I know it. Just try to bring down one at a time.
Most inconvenient.
We've used up all our stuff. This is fast, right? I think? Average? Maybe she'll get this one off. How did we kill them all so quickly? Or is there here's another one. Oh, that didn't sound right. These guys are gonna fight us or what?
Maybe.
Oh, that's cool. Oh, these little spirits, okay.
Got it.
Can't talk to that spirit. Can't talk to that spirit.
Eyes open.
Oh crap. Alright, let's fight it first.
Following your lead.
That's not very helpful.
Way sail, miss. May to.
How may I help? That's not very helpful.
Not very helpful. Just spell, it works. Come on. Can't cast it.
Useless.
That's not very helpful.
Enough.
Let's see what lies this way.
We can go through there, I guess? Oh.
I understand.
Glad you did, none of the rest of you did. I got a chance, because it takes forever to save, I don't know why. We talk to thee. This spirit stands stiffly at attention, her gaze focused on the end of the hallway. One arm bears up a heavy round shield, though the rippling blur of soul energy obscures what lies upon it. Somehow we know how to speak Engwithan. Hello? Her head turns a little. They've passed the blight forges. If the overseers live, we may stop them yet in the chambers beneath. She snorts, if Kabiros and his pack of scheming wizards haven't betrayed us. The mob may be on us soon. Better to make peace with whatever god will have you. She pauses, looking at you. Are you afraid? Afraid of what? Indeed. What's to fear at all? She looks away from you. Our own people turn against us. What remains if we are victorious? Who will feed the machines then?
I was asking what you... what we should be afraid of, or who you're talking about.
I do not fear the battle. I fear what will become of our lord once we are victorious. What further madness the children of the wheel will pour into his ears. Perhaps he would stop once his son is returned to him. But will they let him?
Children of the wheel?
While Adnua confronts himself with his titan, they dig at the very heart of heaven. She gives a sour laugh. Madness. All of it. And yet Adnua,
holds them close at his side. None of this would have happened if not for them. They have driven our great lord from grief and into madness, pushed him into these deeds. She pauses. He was a great king. Perhaps he will be again. Come, we'll rally the defense at the steps. Funnel them into our blades. With the animats beside us, they won't stand a... The spirit gasps, wordlessly, mouth agape. She gropes for something at her back, unseen, and takes a listing step sideways, away from you. Her eyes, wide, gaze into yours. You... Okay. Someone... I'm guessing this is replaying from the past, because we're a watcher and we can see events from the past. And someone stabbed her in the back, and no, it's not me, it's someone else. Her leg buckles, and as she falls, the misty lights, which form her shape, thin and scatter. It's late and I'm tired, guys. Okay.
Time to see and not be seen.
Oh boy. Too many of these damn things. I gotta make sure we're all good here. All except for Kanna. Here we go. Boom.
Yes?
Yes. Is it there stuck behind people? Yeah.
Following your lead.
Okay, that works out. Oh, good. He actually has the right thing. Yeah, just everyone hit the damn thing.
Damn, missed.
Remember how hard these things were? Sheesh.
Keeping an eye out.
Okay, so this goes back this way.
No problem.
Two topazes. Or would the plural just be topaz? Oh, there's a trap here. I've been in here.
See now what the flame has shown us?
Yeah, it shows a trap. You heard me. Oh boy.
And the fire shows me something new.
Oh boy. Isn't there a potion or something for that? Where's those keys? Hold on a second, guys. Itchy ear. Endurance. That's just accuracy. Iron skin. I wonder if Carolan, maybe. Only one and one. Oh, what I put it back in. Damn it. Exit inventory. Get in there. Ugh. I could have sworn there was something though. Don't we have a ring? Oh, that's his,
What?
All right.
What?
Oh, shush.
Hey.
Big strong guy. You're gonna trip the trap.
All right then.
Pieces of stuff falling around. Okay.
Hey.
What?
Okay.
No problem.
Hopefully there's no more traps. The hell is this thing? Broken machine. Engwithan machine part. The exact purpose of this bizarre mechanism is unknown, though it was found within one of the broken machines within the lower reaches of an Engwithan ruin. Oh, like this one right in front of us. It seems largely comprised of Adra and contains several loops of copper. Examining one of the ancient machines in the ruins has yielded a strange mechanism, laced through with copper. It will likely be of interest to the Vithrak. Indeed.